So when we start revising physics, one of the first things that we have to see is the difference between a scalar and a vector quantity. So we know that scalar quantities have size or dimension. They don't have directions, okay? For example, mass. Mass is a scalar quantity. You can have a mass. For example, this duster has a mass. How much matter is inside this duster? But it doesn't have a direction. On the other hand, the weight, that is a force, that has a direction, that is downward. It is pulling downward, right? It's pulling my hand downward. So there is a direction downward, and the weight is a force. So force is a vector. So this is just a small example. Temperature, time, length, speed, energy, all these things are scalar quantities. So when you have length, and when you assign direction to that length, when you say suppose 2 kilometers, okay? So 2 kilometers, that's a scalar quantity. But if you assign a direction to this length, for example, 2 kilometers where? 2 kilometers to the east, for example. Where did you travel? How much did you travel? I traveled 2 kilometers, scalar. In which direction did you travel? I traveled 2 kilometers in the east direction. Then this length becomes a displacement. 2 kilometers to the east, then it becomes a displacement. Okay? This length can also be called a distance. Okay? And when you add a direction, it becomes a vector quantity. So speed, how fast are you traveling? I'm traveling at 10 kilometers per hour. In which direction are you traveling? I'm traveling 10 kilometers per hour in the east direction. Or I'm traveling 10 kilometers per hour towards my school or towards my home. You add a direction, right? So whenever you add a direction to speed, it becomes a velocity. That is the simple difference between scalars and vectors.